And that's what we try to do. When we go out there, we want people to have a good time. They want to, they feel our intensity. You know, they're feeling a certain way. Maybe our music will help them, you know, feel better about their day or let their frustrations or their anger out. They're going to get a really intense, live rock and show, as well as, you know, we hope that they got their money's worth for them.
Yeah, it's too bad I'm not going to see that because you guys aren't coming to Canada, but, you know, that's a topic for another day.
I know.
We'll just move on.
Give me the Canadian guilt, Tina.
Yeah, I know. We're just going to move on, you know, just never mind. I had to know what I would have expected.
If we ever make it close in terms of drivable distance, you should come.
Buffalo, baby. Buffalo.
Go to VIP.
Uh-huh.
Or you'll be VIP.
Aw. Well, go to Buffalo. That's a drivable.
No, we're going to work on that. Work on Buffalo. I'm sure that'll be a stop in the future here.
All right.
We haven't made it out in the last 2 months, but we've been there last year, so you know, hopefully we'll make it out and you'll be able to come out. We'll have a Molson and a Labatt.
And too bad, if you were making it out in the spring, we might even be able to watch the Stanley Cup playoffs, but I'm not sure how many Canadians.
Toronto, I don't know about Toronto's.
Oh, Toronto's done. They're done.
Right now. Yeah, they're done. Montreal went on a free fall lately, so they're 2 points away from clinching. It's that elusive 2 points with six games left, which is the hardest to get, but it's a little closer than they really think. I think they got a little comfortable in the driver's seat, never hitting eighth place, and now they're flirting with disaster.
Yeah. Yeah, well, Toronto's been flirting with disaster since, like, what, the 10th game into the season. Yeah, yeah.
The one thing I'll always say, you got to credit the Leaf fans.
I know, we're diehards, eh? We bleed blue and white. They could lose. Like, how long has it been since we've had a Stanley Cup? Like, 19, you know, I don't know. I wasn't even born yet. So, like, I mean, go figure.
67, we know because we rub it in.
There, yeah, okay, thanks. You know what? You know what?
No, but honestly, that's the thing. You know, and Montreal fans are the same. It's just that we always say, well, we lost this year, but, you know, we got to the third round last year. Or, you know, we're the last Canadian team to win a Stanley Cup.
I know.
So, you know, we always have that, you know, that excuse that we have, that we have the 24th Stanley Cup and all blah, blah, blah. But, you know, technically, Canadian teams haven't had the fortune of, I don't know, drafting well, or it's just been, Ottawa got with the closest. Calgary was a few years back.
But Vancouver's got a good chance this year. Vancouver's smoking.
That's our grace. You know why? If anybody's got to go, and aside from my team, I'm rooting for Vancouver.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course.
Ottawa's in his prime right now.
Yeah, of course. Well, you know, a true Maple Leaf fan, the one thing we say after every season, you know, every year, there's always next year. I say it every year. I'm
always
so...
You always have Don Cherry.
Oh, yeah. God love him. I love Don Cherry. You know what? We're going to bore the crap out of everybody. We're talking about hockey, and I could talk about this for like 5 hours, but...
A girl who likes hockey, you know you're from Canada. That's all I got to say. You don't get too many females to dig hockey in the U.S.
All right, so I'm going to ask you, if you had any advice to give an up-and-coming band trying to make it out there, what would it be, Frankie?
You know, it's always tough. I always have this saying that I learned a long time ago when I left Montreal in 1999. Rob and I hopped on a Greyhound bus from Montreal to L.A. 5.5 days with the wretched of the wretched criminals and, you know, who knows who was on my bus. And it was a tough go, but it was a learning experience. And the reason why we left is because you run out of real estate where we were in Canada. A lot of people are saying, for what you're doing, you're not going to make it. Your friends are not, you know, your friends are going to take you so far. It's not show friends. Show business.
Right.
Your friends will always tell you what you want to hear. You could play a million shows in front of your hometown. But when you go out there and play in, you know, Sheboygan, Wisconsin, to 10 people, and you win them and each person bought a CD or a shirt, that's when you know you're doing something right. On that level, if you're a local band or a regional band, you got to get out there and not be closed-minded in terms of where you're from. And you got to go out and win a crowd. Win any crowd. Win a crowd 7 miles from your house. Win a crowd 700 miles from your house. And then that'll teach you, if you don't, keep trying, you know. I have total respect for every genre or every musician. The guy who stays at home and wants to play in his garage and never wants to make it and wants his music to be cataloged forever in his mind, that's fine. But for the person who complains about how did you guys make it? Why do they deserve to get there and not me? Well, you know, a lot of it has to do with timing. A lot of it has to do with songwriting. You know, I always tell people, listen to your favorite artist who you love the most and notice that songwriting is the key. And then you work on the rest, the stage show, you know, and everything else that comes along with confidence. All this stuff is just key. It's components that you can, intangibles until you get there, you know, and then nobody ever told me about it. I watched and learned. A lot of it was just learning curve, learning experience. I was a shy, timid kid in Montreal. And once I joined the band, it made me, allowed me to, a touring band, and allowed me to play to different people and not play to my friends. It allowed me to come to my show and be a little bit more personal and social and have that, you know, that confidence that we all need to succeed.
Well, you've obviously succeeded because you're like a social friggin' butterfly, man. I'm telling you.
What did I tell you? I think that I fulfilled the needs. Did I come through in Joey's relief?
Yes, you're awesome. I'm glad I got you on the show. I'm glad. Honestly, I can't wait to meet you.
About 416, I was like, well, you know, I'll give this one to Joey, but technically, you know, the Canadian should do it. But not to be biased or nothing. We ended up working out this way.
Yeah, well, it's cool. And, you know, it's funny because I am based just north of Toronto. In Barrie. I don't know if you know where Barrie is.
Oh, yeah. You guys have that big show, the outdoor one. I used to have it.
We used to. We don't have that anymore because they sold the land, and now there's no more concerts there. I mean, if you can believe that. The only really awesome, cool venue that Barrie ever had. Anyways, but yeah, so that's where I am.
Yeah, RDP's used to play. I think we might have played there with my old band a long time ago.
Everybody's played there. Everybody's toured there. Our Lady Peace, Nickelback, Theory of a Dead Man, all these bands, they've all played there. And it was great, but, you know, it's done and, you know, you move on. But now I have to drive all the way down to Toronto, which, as you know, is a trek, just to go and check out some cool bands and cool concerts, you know. But, you know, the big rock show is actually based in the States. But it's cool that you're Canadian. I really had no idea of that.
Yeah, that's, you know, the one thing about it is, you know, like, we don't really harp on anything except for the fact that we were formed and based in Austin. We're not really necessarily, you know, I'm not Texan, nor is Rob, and nor is Jay, really. The thing is, you know, our birthplace in terms of the bands of, you know, Spark and, you know, where we started was Austin. So that's what we call home when we're writing on the road. But, you know, a lot of it is just we've been away from Canada in terms of touring. Like, I haven't played a show, and Rob and I haven't played a show in Montreal or Toronto or anywhere in Canada. Probably since 2003. I mean, we have great memories. I mean, I wouldn't be who I am if it wasn't for touring at the Horseshoe or playing the Rivoli and you know, playing in at the Club Soda in Montreal or, you know, the Commodore in Toronto, in Vancouver.
Yeah.
The Royal Albert in Winnipeg. I mean, these are places that for me, you know, made me who I am. This is the origins of who I am. So I'm hoping that we can work it out and eventually, you know, our career is young enough that we can fix our problems and get over to Canada sooner than later.
That would be very good. Well, Frankie, what else is on the Anew Revolution agenda? What else can fans expect from the band for the rest of this year anyway?
Well, I think we're going to, you know, touring is definitely going to have to wind down just in general. We don't want it to. We feel we have at least two big tours left in us without oversaturating. Because a lot of the time, you know, the people on the inside, the suits, as we call them, they worry about, you know, oversaturating. In today's climate, with records no longer in stores, the only thing you have is live.
Yeah.
Why not? I don't, you know, as long as the people are showing up, if there's a little bit of an indication that we're not wanted, then we'll know. But I think as long as people keep showing up to shows, because I think a person would much rather save his money and spend $20 to go see your show than spend it on a ticket. You know?
So basically what you're saying is touring, and more touring.
Touring, more touring, in the middle with some writing and recording music, but then back to touring, and more touring. It's the only way, you know, the thing is none of us have day jobs. We have to create music, write music, have it be on movies if we can, soundtracks, whatever we can for whatever our music can, so we can make money in other forms or mediums, and of course, sell music at the venues and sell t-shirts and everything that we can, because people buy music at the venue as a memorabilia item, and of course, the music to listen to. But it's an item that we sign, and we go out and meet all our fans every night. I sell the merchandise. It's part of my, like you said, my social butterfly personality. I love to get into the minds of our fans and just to know what they like about what we do, and I like to hear them say, you know, what they want to see from us, you know?
Right on. Is there anything else that you'd like to add today that I didn't ask you, or any messages for your fans out there, Frankie?
Well, I'd say, you know, I say this all the time, and it's maybe a little cliche, but if you hear this interview and you discovered us and you like us, tell somebody. Spread the word, because that's all we have right now with the Facebooks and, you know, the other social internet mediums. Just go out and spread the word about us, and let somebody else know that you like us and what kind of band we are, and maybe they'll like us too.
Well, I certainly like you. I love you guys. and I can't thank you enough for taking the time out to chat with me today. Best of luck on all the tours and continued success to A New Revolution. You guys rock.
Thank you very much, Tina. And it was an honor to speak to a Canadian.
Well, thank you. And it was a real honor and surprise to speak to a fellow Canadian, but more importantly, to a great band member and a terrific band. I love you guys. You really are killer.
Thank you very much, Tina. I want to burn myself. I want to cut my skin just so I feel something. Hey, this is Frank from The New Revolution, and you're listening to Tina, my good old friend Tina, on The Big Rock Show. I keep banging my head against this wall. I keep running away, but still I find my way back home. All I can see is ashes falling from the stars.
The Big Rock Show, Thursdays, 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, with your host, Tina Peak, on America's number one source for independent and local music, OutboundMusic.com. For more information, visit OutboundMusic.com or TheBigRockShow.net.